being enacted. So two provisions have been quoted in this act to make this law. One is 175(2) and Article 191, sir. Now, may I take your lordship to Article 191 of the Constitution? My humble submission is, my proposition before your lordship is, subject to the Constitution and law, the Supreme Court may make rules regulating the practice and procedure of the court. So, my lord, my humble submission is that the only authority which can make rules regulating the practice and procedure of the court is the Honorable Supreme Court and not the Parliament, sir. This is my humble submission. And I, for that purpose, I'll say that subject to the Constitution and law does not mean that the Parliament can legislate. So subject to law, subject to Constitution, has it been interpreted in Imrana Tiwana's case, my lord? Okay, basically, subject to means a restriction, sir. It is not an enabling provision. And subject to Constitution has been dealt with in the case of Imrana Tiwana, and I'll come to subject to law after that. 2015 SCMR 1739 at page 1765. 2015 SCMR 1739 at page 1765, para 53. My lord.
Chaliye.
The word subject to Constitution do not therefore make Article 137(1) subservient to the remaining provisions of the Constitution. All that these mean is that where the Constitution creates a specific bar to the exercise of such executive or legislative authority or provides a different manner for such exercise, then the authority must either not be exercised at all or exercised in such manner as the Constitution permits. It does not mean that provision prefaced with such words is a subordinate constitutional provision. It also cannot mean once the province has devolved certain powers on the local, its legislative executive authorities faced by the local government. So basically, it is a restrictive thing and says that it's a bar, not a enabling provision for legislation. Then what is the meaning of subject to law? My humble submission is that subject to law does not mean, implies the implementation rather than grant of power, number one. It implies limitation rather than grant of power. If rulemaking power is made subject to legislation, sir, then the rulemaking power of Supreme Court will become functus officio. Constitutional grant of rulemaking power is construed as a continuing power, sir. So there cannot be any limitations on that, or constitutional power given that. It is not an enabling provision. Subject cannot mean subject to legislation, sir. If subject law is interpreted, the Supreme Court's rulemaking power are subject to, then that would be a grave violation of independence and separation of powers doctrine, sir. Subject of mean substantive law. Subject to law means subjective, substantive law as distinguished from pleading and practice. Substantive law includes much more than legislation. It includes common law. Subject to law means rulemaking power as to practice must not invade the field of substantive law. So there has to be something existing. It cannot invade the field of substantive law. But it does not give them the power to legislate, sir. And, sir, with your lordship's kind permission, I have prepared
what a... What you're saying is that the Parliament cannot make rules.
Rules.
Nor legislate regarding the rules.
Rules.
And all the Parliament can do is, subsequent legislation nahi ho sakti. Ye jo existing law tha, uske ek daire kar mein rehte hue, aur kanun,
aap rules nahi bana sakte.
Daire kar mein rehte hue, power in any event vests in the Supreme Court.
Supreme Court, exclusively, sir. Because the word used is not just rule making, it is regulate. That we can, by rule, regulate the practice.
Now, I'll read the provision.
Yes, my lord.
Let's reframe the whole provision.
My lord.
It says, now let's read it like this.
My lord.
The Supreme Court may make rules regulating the practice and procedure of the court.
Yes, my lord.
So are you saying that Supreme Court had to be advised about the Constitution, had to be advised about the law because it would make rules which will be completely in violation of the constitution and the law. So it would have been much simpler drafting to start it with the Supreme Court may make rules regulating practice and procedure of the court. Your contention is that a high body, as a constitutional body, as a Supreme Court, had to be reminded that there is a constitution in existence. Don't violate it. That's a very strange proposition.
No.
You are putting redundancy to the words subject to the constitution and law, because what you are saying can equally be said by deleting these words.
My lord, with utmost respect, my lord.
Let's hear the counsel. Please sun lete hain counsel ko.
I'm also reading it the same way. The Supreme Court may make rules and regulating the practice and procedure of the court,
my lord,
subject to the constitution and the law.
My lord,
which means Supreme Court can make rules.
Yes.
Whatever rules it wants to make.
Ji.
But it can't go
beyond the constitution or any law which already exists.
So there is a limitation.
Mera sawal apni jagah thehra, Hazur, aap jawab to de
diye. Ji, my lord, with utmost respect, I'm not reading it.
Utmost respect ko chhodiye, sirf jawab de dijiye.
Acha sir, aapke saath.
Mera waqt ki kami hai.
Ji, I know, my lord. I'm just saying that subject to law, subject means some kind of restriction.
Main aapse kuch aur maine aapse baat. Acha, fir se aap dekhen. जो मैंने सवाल है उसका तो आप जवाब
नहीं मैं आ तो जाऊं उसमें
नहीं आप आएंगे तो अगर दिल निकल जाएगा मैंने कहा अगर ये हम लव्स काट दें सब्जेक्ट टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड द लॉ फर्क क्या पड़ेगा फिर
जी
ये इसका सवाल का जवाब दे दीजिए
फर्क ये पड़ेगा फर्क नहीं